Hello everyone, it's Cecilia from the Language Nook, and today we're going to talk about international exams. Is it really necessary to take them? Let's see. So, do you really need to take an international exam? I like seeing international exams as a kind of passport that make your life easier if you're planning to live abroad. But whether you need to take an exam or not depends on your goals. If you want to, let's say, get a working holiday visa for New Zealand, or have an unskilled job, or a job in which you don't have to use English professionally a lot, like, let's say, participate in meetings, write emails, make phone calls. If you just need English for your everyday conversation with your colleagues and your boss, then my answer would be no, you don't really need one. But if you want to apply for a work and holiday visa in Australia, or you want to apply for residency or a university, then you need one. You need an international exam. Also, for some kinds of jobs, very skilled jobs like a doctor, nurse, you need an international exam as well in order to use your profession in the English-speaking country. International English exams make up a whole world. There are so many of them. You have IELTS, TOEFL, which is the most academic international exam out there. You have First Certificate. You have CAE, which is the Advanced English Language Test. You also have PTE and also OET. There are many. IELTS is not the only one. And the one that you choose will depend on what your goal is. But in this video, we're going to focus on IELTS because it's the most popular, because it's recognized in over 140 countries. So it's very popular, and that's the one that most people decide to take. Now, because IELTS is one of the most popular English exams out there, there's a huge advantage, and that is that the internet is full of free resources for you to take advantage of. There are many things that you can do yourself in order to prepare for this exam without needing a teacher. And that might sound strange coming from a teacher who prepares for IELTS, but it's true. There are so many free resources that I think everybody planning to take IELTS should take advantage of. And one of them is the British Council website. They have many free resources there. And of course, the IELTS official website as well. If you live in Auckland, Auckland Library has free resources and classes sometimes, so you should check out their website. And another one that I particularly like is FutureLearn. FutureLearn is a platform that you might know already, and it's full of courses about any topic in the world. You can study absolutely everything there, and they have some IELTS courses. So if you're interested, you can go sign up. It's free. I mean, you have the option to pay, but you don't really have to. And prepare by yourself. Then when you feel confident enough, when you feel that you have learned whatever you could do by yourself, learn by yourself, then my suggestion is to get help, because it's very useful to have someone give you feedback for your speaking and also your writing. So it might be useful for you to have someone telling you what your problems are, but that's a topic for another video, so I just wanted to mention it briefly. If you know that you will need IELTS in the future, my advice is to prepare in advance. And when I say in advance, I mean months in advance, not just weeks in advance. Usually people need IELTS for a serious reason, like I said before, for applying for residency or a university. Usually those are stressful situations, and preparing for IELTS takes a lot of time, effort, and energy, a lot. So you don't want to leave it until the last minute. You don't want to add an extra layer of stress to your life. So prepare in advance, but not too much in advance, because something to take into account is that IELTS results are valid for 2 years. So don't take the exam 2 years before you need it. Just keep that in mind. So what if you don't really need to take IELTS because you already have residency or the visa that you want? Should you take it anyway? Is it still a good idea to invest all this time and money into preparing for this exam and taking it? Well, it depends on your personality, I guess. Preparing for this exam can bring you many benefits. The skills that are tested in this test, are the skills that you use every day. And preparing for the test will help you polish those skills. And that's a good idea. So for example, in the listening section of the test, you have to multitask because you have to be listening and also reading at the same time and trying not to miss any answers. And that's something that we do every day. Writing is something that we do every day as well. We write emails, we write messages. Some people write content for LinkedIn, Facebook, whatever. And preparing for IELTS writing will give you the skills that you need in order to improve your writing. And then another example is speaking, because IELTS speaking test, it's a conversation between you and the examiner. It's a friendly conversation. Of course, it's a test and it's going to be a little bit stressful, but it doesn't have to be, it's not meant to be. Practicing for this part of the exam will improve your conversation skills as well. So I think it's not a waste of time. Even if you don't really need the exam, it's still not a waste of time to prepare for it and take it. Also, it's something nice to add to your CV. I mean, you don't have to, but why not? It could be very interesting for an employer to see what you are able to do in terms of English. So, in a nutshell, is it really necessary to take an international exam? Well, it depends on your goals, but whether you need to take them or not, training for them will for sure improve your language skills. And that is an advantage, isn't it? That was it for today. I hope you have enjoyed the video and see you next time. Bye!